Hello, today I would like to show you the AWS IoT Greengrass deployment. That is not necessarily the production level type of deployment, it's more for educational purposes. But it is pretty solid setup, so you might use it if you need to handle only a few Greengrass devices. Speaking about Greengrass, Greengrass is AWS service that you use on your local hardware to connect with AWS Cloud to send telemetry data and to enable secure remote management of your infrastructure and applications that you host on your Greengrass device. This is the sample deployment. We've got three steps. The first step is the Python script that creates the local assets, so assets on our Greengrass device. Those assets there are used as the input for the Cloud Development Kit. Cloud Development Kit is a suggested tool to handle the AWS infrastructure. We're using CDK to create assets in AWS Cloud, and those assets will be used by the Greengrass at the very end. Then the output of CDK goes once again as an input to our Python script to obtain final data and generate the configuration file. Now let's look at this process in a bit more details. This is the first Python script. It generates the private key. The private key is extremely important and it should be handled with care. Whenever possible, you should generate the private key on a device that's going to use that private key, and you should not share it with anyone else. In order to obtain a certificate related to this private key, we are going to use the CSR, the certificate signing request. So this Python script, once it generates the private key, it generates CSR as well. Then this CSR is used in our Cloud Development Kit. So based on that file, we are generating the X509 certificate in AWS Cloud. Apart from the certificate, CDK creates for us the IoT thing. The IoT thing is a virtual representation of our Greengrass device. We create the IoT policy. The IoT policy defines allowed actions for our Greengrass device. For instance, topics that this device is allowed to subscribe and publish. Additionally, we create the role alias. The role alias is very important because it allows our Greengrass device to access other AWS services. And our IoT policy allows to use this role alias. Role alias points to the IAM role, and IAM role got specific IAM policy attached. That IAM policy defines actions allowed to our Greengrass device. Once again, we handle everything using CDK, which is pretty important. Finally, we obtain the AWS IoT core endpoints, the data endpoint and the credentials endpoint. Those endpoints we will use in the configuration of our Greengrass service. Finally, we run the second Python script on our local device. This script downloads this certificate. Once again, without revealing the private key, we were able to obtain certificate, and now we've got this private key and certificate pair on our local device. And as a final step, we generate the Greengrass config file. The Greengrass config file is very important because it's got all data needed by Greengrass to operate properly. So this is how our final outcome looks like. We've got our Greengrass service with all assets. The Greengrass itself is just a Java application that we can install on any device. And we've got our AWS infrastructure ready. So once we've got this type of setup, our Greengrass device can access the IoT core, can access other AWS services that are allowed by this IAM role, and can operate, can send telemetry data, and we can deploy applications remotely. I will handle all of that during my training. Thank you for attention. Let me know if you've got any questions. All the best. LMTX.